Hello folks, very good morning. We'll start in 5 minutes. I think we have a practice session today as well. Please open your Jupyter notebooks and keep them ready. And if you are facing any issues from previous sessions, you can type in the chat any concerns you want to talk or any feedback. I'd be glad to listen. Just type in the chat. Hey Avinash, I wanted to tell it to today about Python section. Python session. We'll be doing it on Sunday. I'll be informing you timings, mostly Sunday 9 to 11, something like that. Just wanted to know how many of how many of you are really willing for that actually? So how many of you really need it? Okay. Okay, money. You can raise your hands, guys. Okay, the crowd has been dwindling, maybe due to presence of recordings. By the way, this is the last recording I'm gonna give you. After this, you have to request only over email. Okay, Ramakrishna, sure. Definitely Ramakrishna. I think we have spoken. You can attend. Okay. Okay, got it. Fine, it seems pretty good number of people are interested. I think not everyone is here as well. So Let's see. And also, guys, recording access, I as I told you, first five recordings I promised to give to everyone. This is the fifth session. Actually, technically it's sixth, but one session we didn't take it in the middle. So today's recording will be the last recording to given to you. Also, I have given an email saying that we are planning to give recording access, complete all the 50 sessions at an extra price to compensate the streaming service. I'll inform it about a week late, maybe by Monday, I'll email you about the details for the same. So those of you who are willing to take up recordings extra, full recordings extra, so I'll reveal the details. The price will be around 1500 per student, because I took a basic survey and not many people are interested. So if more people are interested, then the cost will come down. I'm just passing the actual cost to you guys for the next 4 months, maintaining a server to stream to the all the people. Okay, so also I still get emails about recordings and material. Just give me 24 hours. And also we have Ashwini here. She will be the teaching assistant for this course. I'll add her to WhatsApp group as well. I think she's on WhatsApp group. So in case you have any issues with material, you can just tag her and ask her. Or you can mail ashwini@supervisedlearning.com as well. But give us 24 hours time. Within 24 hours, material will be uploaded after the session. Right? The regular expressions code has also been uploaded already. And any issues are there, you can let me know. And guys, please keep practicing. Don't skip sessions. Wake up and join. I hope, like most of the people who started waking up early and joining this like fifth session, you're enjoying the experience. Right? Let's start today's class. See, today's class is mostly on pre-processing as well. Okay. And when I call it pre-processing, it's not about just coding something, but it's about understanding why we are doing it as well. Of course, these are the topics which we are discussing since ambiguity. Even in the demo also I have discussed, but I will just revise. Okay, and this is a slide sheet with tables for regular expressions. All this have already been discussed in the regular expression class. I just wanted to summarize it and give it in the form of a slide. So after the slide is uploaded today, you can have a look at it. So coming to tokenization part, if you remember, I was discussing in the start, the sentences or all sentences and paragraphs is the routine form of our text basically. Now, but the computer doesn't understand sentences, you have to break it into words only. Every pre-processing step is always conversion of sentences into words. Like you wanted to do chunking, you wanted to do POS tagging, you wanted to do parsing, you want to do sentiment analysis, whatever the task may be in NLP, the first step is always tokenization. And it is very crucial step because you do it every day. Now, we also discussed the challenges in tokenization as well. Okay, first of all, punctuation especially. You have a comma and a full stop. After salutation, full stop. That's a point of ambiguity. Let's say apostrophe, India's capital. How to split it? India plus capital S or India's or India's? How do you split it? So if you're basically splitting it plus India plus S, you're losing the meaning here, right? Why? Because what is India apostrophe S means? It means that the following word belongs to India. And when you say India plus yes, and the next word obviously becomes plus capital. the entire meaning is lost.
So how do you deal with this challenge basically? And okay, let's say Prithvi, I'll not tokenize it as India plus S. I'll retain it as India apostrophe S. That will be a single token. Then my next question will be, is it the same every time? All right. Is it the same every time? Prithvi's class or Prithvi's car? So you have to consider all possible scenarios. So a tokenizer, so we are not solving that problem now, but I want to make it clear that tokenization algorithm deals with all these challenges. Let's say I am, I plus M, I plus AM. Okay, and one more thing, as always, I use it to say social media is always a big challenge for us, especially if you are taking text from not so well-written English. These days, people are writing spoken English in the written format. So in those cases, tokenization becomes really big challenge. And then New Delhi. How do you do New Delhi? Just a moment, guys. So if you write a tokenization algorithm, if I really ask you to write a tokenization algorithm, first thing everyone will do is split the sentence, dot split, take the sentence, use dot split, inside you'll use a space basically. The same thing I have taught you sometime back basically. Now, if I split New Delhi with that space basically, you're losing the meaning. San Francisco, New York. Okay. How do you know, first of all, these are the words which are left with spaces, but they have a meaning only when they're together. There are many such words in the dictionary. New Delhi is a single word, but you don't write with space. So your tokenization algorithm will have to take care of these things also. And the final thing in the tokenization algorithm is, it is also language specific. French is different from Germany. Chinese is different from Japanese. So if you write a tokenization algorithm, it is not the same for every language. It again differs from language to language. Fortunately, in Indian languages, these are like well-written languages, pronounced and written in the same way. Tokenization is not a big challenge. But I don't know Chinese script basically, but Chinese doesn't have spaces basically. If you have ever noticed, the native Chinese, when they write, they don't give spaces. They write like this, the cat in the hat. Okay, assume this is Chinese, although it's not Chinese, because no one understands Chinese. I take English script only, explain it. Now, when you get a sentence like this, how do you convert it into tokens? Because the tokenization, one of the biggest advantages, you have spaces in between. 90% of your problem is solved. You write, see guys, I'll tell you, S dot split. Someone is tapping in chat. Any concerns? The screen share is on, guys. Everyone can see. Only Himanshu facing issue. It's working. Okay. Yeah. Avinash, as you said, German is also the same problem. Okay. Himanshu, just have a look at your internet. So let's say S is equal to some sentence in class. I do S dot split with a space. Just a space has been given. Right? This output, you get tokens, right? You are 90% accurate, guys. I'm telling you, with the split, space. Only special case, how many do you think that apostrophe is like this come and New Delhi like this come? Less than 10% of times. But of course, they are more important as well. So, but this is only for English. What will you do in Chinese? There's no space. Right? So, in case of languages like Chinese, there is something called maximum match segmentation algorithm basically. Okay, again, this is a naive algorithm and it doesn't work like seamless, but this is the first step in understanding the algorithm. Let's see how we proceed with the cat in the hat. How do you tokenize it? What people generally start is they start with the word T. They start with the word T, and now first step will be pick the first character and find the longest word in the dictionary matching with the string. Okay. Take the entire string, the cat in the hat, and see if it is there in the dictionary. No. Then second step, remove one word. First step, the cat in the hat. Second dictionary. Not found. Then what do you do? The cat, INTHEHA. Remove T. Again, check in dictionary. So not found. You'll make it until the cat in the H. Okay, again check in the dictionary. So basically you are looking for a dictionary word which matches based on this sentences basically. What happens until the comes into the dictionary? There's no matching word. The cat is not a single word. The cat in, not a single word. The cat in the, not a word. So until you come to E, you don't find anything in the dictionary. So what it becomes is the plus cat in the hat. Now second same step. Search cat in the hat. Check in dictionary. Obviously it will not be there. Not found. What will you do? Reduce one word from the last. Cat in the hat. H-A. Omit T. Again, check in dictionary. Not found. So when will it will be found? It will be found only when you get cat. Cat in is not there. Cat in the is not there. So the second step outward will be the plus cat plus in the hat. And the steps repeat until the tokenization comes. The cat plus in place the hat. It will become. And finally, the place cat plus in plus the plus. That's how you tokenize with the maximum match segmentation algorithm. Yes, Samba, very expensive. See, I have taken a very small phrase, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 words. Just imagine the sentence with around 20 words. Every time checking in the dictionary is, of course, you have ways to speed it up. You have ways to speed it up also. So, and there is one more challenge here, guys. Let's say the cat is, I can't think of a word, but let's say the cat itself is a dictionary word. Okay. The cat. And if it is a dictionary word, what will happen, guys? If it is a dictionary word, in the step one itself, you won't come to the. the cat will be dictionary word, then in the hat will proceed with it. So here one of the assumption you are making here is basically the smallest word itself is in the dictionary. There are no two words combinations that will be in the dictionary. Of course, Chinese follows the Chinese never have come up with such problem. But English, if I think I can tell two or three examples saying that two words merge it, then you get a new word that might be in the dictionary. So if the longer word is in the dictionary, then what happens? We are coming from the last basically. Hat gone, A gone, H gone, E gone, H gone, T gone, E, I gone. I gone. If the cat itself is in the dictionary, you'll stop it here, right? Why will you go to up to the again? You'll take this word. But what if it is there in the dictionary? But what we want the plus cat. So that is an ambiguous situation. If at so maximum match segmentation algorithm work seamlessly in Chinese, but you use it for English, it fails because we have a lot of word combinations which will be used both in your as a single word, as a double word, basically. Okay. So this is one of the algorithm. If you want to try, you can try implementing it if you have time, any one of you. But implementing some of these algorithms from scratch will give you very good profile. Let's say if you're going for an NLP engineer role, you showcase something like you implemented a tokenization on yourself, you implemented a POS tagging on yourself, then that will give immense weightage to your profile. So as a part of course, I keep on giving you hints where you can work. If you come back with the work, I will happily review it also. But there's no force like, okay, if you do this, I'll evaluate and give you marks. Like this is voluntary. Okay. So, and when it comes to tokenization, the single rule here, it's again, we come back to English. One algorithm doesn't fit all use cases. Right. And a newly designed tokenizer is validated with manual tokenizer library. That means you have some sentences already. They have been correctly tokenized, just like train and test split. That's it. And then you can go and verify them actually. So I'm giving you a pet project, one more pet project. You can design, you can implement max match segmentation algorithm, or you can design your own tokenizer, a very basic one. I mean, it doesn't take more than 20 lines of code, guys, to implement a tokenizer. As I told you, the first split, the first step, sentence dot split, and you keep quotes, give a space, that itself tokenizes your text to 90% accuracy. After that, you have to put conditions. So you can test it on Wall Street Journal text. Wall Street Journal, lot of articles are there. These lot of articles are stored as a corpus in NLTK. And you have the text here, you have the tokens here. Write algorithm, first one, write algorithm. When I say algorithm, don't think it's like complex SQLN algorithm. It's like 20 lines of script basically. Not even 20, 15, 10 lines mein ho jayega. Write algorithm, second, tokenize on, where will you tokenize? Tokenize on this, and from this, take output and compare with this. Basically, so you will know your tokenization accuracy. Okay, don't think that it's going over your head. We will do hands-on once this theory has been done. It will get very clear for you. And guys who are almost at zero level in Python, please don't worry. The feedback has reached me late. I assume that the Python tutorial which has been shared to you was enough, but don't at all worry. I'll make sure that you'll come on the same level. Okay. if necessary, we'll take more sessions also on Python. Okay, so let's do a hands-on on tokenization, and after that we'll go to stemming and lemmatization. Okay. Okay, Vikas is saying something. In dictionary for a single word, we have multiple many meanings. How will it pick correct matching meaning? Okay. Today we will not be discussing about the meaning part of it. For now, the goal is to tokenize word or tokenize the word basically. Meaning, I have already talked about semantic ambiguities situation, and there is a whole new topic called word sense disambiguation. Word sense disambiguation means the same problem you have asked for, the same, exactly same. So we have a full 2 hours discussion on that once we reach NLP applications. Okay, thank you Vikas for asking. Okay, let's start with tokenization today. Okay guys, I hope you can see the screen. I'm zooming it a bit. Okay, and please open Jupyter Notebooks and be ready to do the visuals. So the first step is, I'm taking a raw statement, something string. You can copy some sentence from anywhere, or else if you okay, let me give this same sentence to you. Okay, I have dropped the text in the chat. Copy it and read it. We'll be doing tokenization here. Amanjit, I don't know how to answer that basically. Maybe it's my way of teaching, right? Because in the morning everyone are sleepy, to get attention I am always saying this is the problem, this is the problem, then people will be like okay okay, I'll listen to you. So there has been a lot of good things in NLP, of course. By the way, I wanted to tell you this thing. Do this emojis analysis also on your chat. Who is using a lot of emojis, like girls and like a girl, and who is not at all using emojis, and what is the most frequent emoji? Okay guys, I hope you have read the text basically and taken it as a raw statement. Media is okay. I think you can read emojis as well. So let's do a very basic split Okay, split is the implementation from NLTK. Raw dot split. Okay, if you don't give anything to the split, it assumes by default it's a space. Right? Now, this sentence is intentionally taken to show you what is a good tokenization, what is not good tokenization. Can you see what is the problem here in the output? Did we get a correct tokenization? When I say tokenization, I just want words. I don't want anything else. Okay, really? Okay. I hope you can see the Jupyter notebook now. No one pointed it till now. Guys, just try this raw dot split, the fourth statement, and let me know. Folks, let me know once you're done with this. Split requires a non-empty pattern. No, just follow this. Okay. Just try to give the space. Right. If you try the syntax as it is, you'll not get any error, guys. I'll tell you. Don't go to that statement. I'm just asking you about third one only. R is like conveying a pattern basically there. I think R should be there. Never tried it without. Please try it and let me know, Pravin. Yes, Guna, I'll explain you the third statement. Okay, now I do R dot split and vertical action similar, which is faster in both. Okay, hold on, my friend. Yes, Chetna, you are right, it will read as Unicode values. Okay, so raw dot split, basically it is nothing but using the split function in the default NLTK library. So if you are not passing any delimiter, it is basically trying to take the split space as a limiter. So dot split is a part of NLTK function. I don't think it's NLTK, even it, I think it should be a part of basic Python libraries only. So as a string operators, as a part of strings basically. So this is a very naive way, the third line of splitting. But what happened here in the output C, I not in a very hopeful tone though, okay? I have a brackets here, okay? Text in the brackets, but I don't want these brackets to come along with not. If you have noticed, not has included a bracket. That's not a correct way to tokenize. Though, this is not a correct way again. Again, let's say there are a lot of mistakes again. The full stop is included in the tokens. The spaces are included in the tokens. So this very naive way of splitting is not right. It's not considering the exceptional cases. So what we do is we go to regular expressions. Regular expression has a way to split with spaces, just with spaces, and you try to split it basically. And there is no much difference because raw dot split is a Pythonic way, re dot split is regular expression way, but the way is like you are just checking the space and you are splitting it. So most of the time I think it is the same output you will get. Okay. If you want to get anything better in the regular expression itself, you can, instead of space, you can use something called backslash s plus. That means no white space character basically. That means any character which is not at all white space, you split it. If there is a white space. So you try to split it with that. Without any white space character. Sorry. Guys, don't type such things in the chat. You're not given a space, Srinivas. Wait. Let me read the previous chat. Does it say where? Yes, where exactly? Wherever there is a white space, you just split it. Avinash, I'm not sure about Unicode 8 and 16 coding. As far as I know, you have to understand what is your source format is in, and based on that, you have to give that encoding basically. Step 6, yes, I am at step 6. Okay, yeah, UTF-8 is default. Yes, just a moment. Not in a very hopeful tone to... So basically this using any no white space character is nothing but I think it covers the spaces and indents also, basically indents or tabs or such things it tries to cover. So you can see that output is as good as the same output where we used a single space in the previous command. So there is no much difference here. Example, I'm typing text data. Okay, all the single spaces are sorted out as a, okay. Let me see. It is not giving any spaces as output. If you notice here, if I'm using RES plus, even the space at the last basically is given as a separate token. Okay, in case you are using re.split just a space, I don't think space will be output given as a token. Now comes the best part. If you are using this W, capital W, whenever you get a word, then it will be split. So that means it can be split on capital A to Z or small A to Z or 0 to 9. And capital W indicates that you can split on anything apart from small a to z, capital A to Z and 0 to 9. So it's like negation. Small W you use, it will split on any of this. Capital W if you use, it will not split on this, but anything else, it will split on it. So just try to split the statement here. And if you can notice, we have got really good tokens here. We have come across opening braces and it has split here. If you have come across closing braces, you have split here. You have come across space, split done. So basically when you split using capital W, you will be left with only words, the splits which has only words starting with. There is no difference, Sridhar. There's no difference. 6 and 7 are the same. You're asking 6 and 7 and 5 and 6. 5 and 6, right? Let me have a look. So 5 and 6, we don't have any difference. Absolutely no difference. But in case you have other non-white space characters, white space character, see here, what we have used is only one space. But when you have a paragraph with next line or indentations or any other non-white space characters, white space characters, then this may not work. The fifth may not work. The sixth will work. You can try it out yourself by giving tab and indent in the strings basically. Yes, try both of it. Small W also you use it and try it. Guys, wait, wait, wait. Lot in private chat as well. Just hold on. I'm looking at him. Yes. If you use small w, basically what is the small w indicates? It will split on any a to z 0 to 9. That means you don't get anything. Basically it sees anything here, it will split you. It will split it. So you have to use capital W to get the tokens. Chetna, can you hear me now? I gave you time to type it and see it for yourself. So yes. Yes. Ashwini, only capital W works basically, because if you have to get a word, you have to use split on the word basically. That means capital W. I mean, it is defined like that. The difference between capital W and small w is small w, you will split on commas, hyphens, brackets, something like that. Sorry, capital W splits on commas, hyphens, spaces and all. So when you split on commas, hyphens, spaces and all, what you will be left with? You will be left with only words, your tokens. When you use small w, it is exactly opposite. Basically you will be splitting on the words. Like it will come across any word like I, A, B, C, D, and it will split it. So when you use small w, you'll be left with punctuations only, and when you use capital W, you'll be left with words. The split is defined like that. Okay, got it. Someone is so confused that they want to split me. Really? Okay. If you split me, there is no one to refund you also. With small w and capital W, it is vice versa with common. So right, thanks. Guys, every one of you, tried it so far? See, I'm just giving you different ways to split. That's it. Okay. Not always differences will be there. You have to figure it out for yourself. Superb. Okay. So this final way in regular expressions, R, W plus, this is one of the really good ways. Okay. Now let's use nltk.wordtokenize. Till now, what we were using is we are writing in the algorithmic way. When I say algorithmic way, take the root functions of Python and do it. NLTK has an implementation called nltk.tokenize.wordtokenize. When you use it, it takes care of everything basically. Hyphens, apostrophes, brackets, full stops, spaces, non-white spaces, white spaces. It takes care of everything. So that's what I called a tokenizer in the starting. And that's what I wanted you to write as word tokenize. So whatever there is inside the word tokenize, okay, what it actually is inside, I want you to replicate it. I want you to write on yourself. So these are your crude points. Basically, you can start off with 6 or 7 commands I have given you. See what is working, what is not working, and how to make it work. Again, a pet project. So as far as course is concerned, you can just do this. and import analytic. So I took another string. Just loading. Also, I will give you the string. Okay. Okay, guys, use NLTK got word tokenize. The syntax is here and you can see the output. Basically, you can try the previous tokenizers also. Really? It shouldn't be giving that. My word tokenizer is pretty clean. Let me see for 40 statements. Yes. Right. Commas and full stops are separated basically into different tokens. I'm fine even if the punctuation is separated and kept as a different token, but I'm not fine if punctuation is included inside a token. That's a problem. Try giving different cases to this word tokenize. I mean, all the three examples which I have given to you, and see if it's working or not, whether you can find any faults which is not working. Just a moment, guys. We have 36 people trained here today.
Okay. Try giving the previous situations also to word tokenize and let me know if it's working or not. Okay, okay. See, in a word tokenizer, the problem is when a single token contains punctuation or other things, basically punctuations or spaces and all. Tokens should always be unique and it should be like they should be found in dictionary. Of course, your source doesn't have a word in dictionary, I can't do anything. But if your source has a dictionary word and after you tokenize you don't find it in dictionary, then you're making a mistake basically. Folks, just keep trying. We'll be back within 5 minutes.
Okay, guys, I'm back. Let me check uppercase. Yes, Chetna, you're right. So based upon the requirement, we use W or W. Srijo, I think your NLT key is not installed, first of all. Okay. Amanjit corrected it. Okay, capital red. Okay, anything? Okay, Praveen answer is solved. Harish. Okay, guys. I think you had enough practice. So I'm just giving you different ways to tokenize text here. That's it. So just remember that we have multiple things always. Rupesh, do you have access to course? Okay. Week one, installation instructions. There's a file. Please go through it. It will solve your problems. Srinivas, I think either your NLT key is not installed or you're not using right syntax. Okay, let me proceed further. So in NLTK, not only have a word tokenized algorithm, there is also regular expression tokenizer also. You can use regular expression tokenizers from NLTK, a bit more sophisticated, and give a pattern basically. Again, the same thing which we have used, small w, capital W. And if you use that, you'll be getting, again, good tokens. I think the syntax is different here. We were using capital W in the previous case when we used the word tokenized directly here. But when we are using regular expression tokenizers from NLTK, it's small w. So tokenizer, you have to initialize it. From tokenizer, you have to use tokenizer or tokenize string. Okay, let me tell you guys, there are at least 20 to 30 ways of tokenizations in NLTK itself. Okay, as the application demands, as you understand more and more about tokenizations, you will do it. And I'll tell you, for 90% of NLP applications, some tokenization will be fine. Okay, you will not be going very finer details into what has happened, why it has happened. So when your text is so dirty and your tokenization is very important, then it will be a pain in ass. Basically, you have to figure out which tokenizer is working. Sometimes it may be possible that you have to use 2-3 tokenizers and merge the tokens and do some pre-processing. People say that pre-processing in data science itself takes 80% time. In NLP, I will tell it is more than 95% of the times. So especially text from coming from social media or web or logs data, especially there is a lot of companies, either cloud-based or server-based companies, they generate logs. And this log analysis has been one of the crucial area of research in NLP also. And if anyone has, I don't have any log files as on now, but if you have seen log files, they definitely go through a pattern, but getting that pattern is really difficult. So if you have to work on log files, then you have to be very patient and use the tokenizers. Yes, anything. It can be either web logs, server logs, or... Okay. I'll tell you what is a log. Log is like a computer generated text file. Let's say you type an error. Sorry, you type a code and you get an error basically. The error can be simply called as a log. What happens is that a lot of softwares or let's say servers, when they keep running, they keep on generating text saying that, okay, let's say you have a Hadoop ecosystem, let's say 30 servers are in a cluster. So each node keeps on communicating with other nodes, and at every second, it says that I communicated with all 29, all 29 pinged me back. So it will keep a notes of it, and the notes will get printed at the end of the day or something like that. Or any language, for example, any language, any system, people generate it such that logs are generated so that they'll understand if any problem has happened, the log file, they'll go and check. Okay, so, and finally, I'm just showing a simple pre-processing step. I'm just converting all the tokens into lower letter. Token is equal to token.lower for token in tokens. Okay, just try this last one. If you're done with last one, we'll go to stemming and lemmatization. No, that was a Harish, that was what I'm telling you. Syntax has changed. If you are using direct regular expression, you have to use capital W. And if you are using the regular expression tokenizer through NLTK corpus, it's small W. And unfortunately, we have to remember all this syntax. Okay, guys, have you tried up everyone? Tokenizer.tokenize 14th line. I want everyone to write 14th line. Okay, great. And guys, how many of you are in Hyderabad? I'm just thinking of a small meetup for a weekend. Maybe not this weekend. Me, Harish is here. I know Harish. Sampath is here. If biryani is offered with lassi, then I come to Hyderabad. Wow. I stay in Gachibowli, guys. I stay in Gachibowli. My flat is big enough to accommodate 20 people. So, okay, I see a lot of people. It will be a good opportunity to meet up. Let's plan. Maybe I cannot serve biryani, but I'll serve something. Don't worry. Chetna, you can come over. Okay, Raghu. Wow. And Raju is here, right? Guna, Samba, nice, nice, nice. Himanshu, wow, okay. Oh, guys, I mean, a lot of yes. That means I can plan something this weekend only. I'll let you know, guys. I'll let you know through email, please, or at least WhatsApp group also. Anything is fine. Okay, so this is about tokenization. Maybe if you go through any other, any online resources, you'll get one or two ways. But I just wanted to show you all at least 8 to 10 ways of tokenizing the text. And let me tell you, there are at least 10 more ways to do. Okay. So it's all about what you need. And and again, when you get a huge corpus, the basic agenda is like take a small sample, let's say paragraph, and tokenize it and see whether it is meeting your needs or not. And then proceed and use that tokenization. That's it. So, So let me go to the lemmatization and stemming part. Okay, one algorithm doesn't fit all cases. I discussed already this thing done. So lemmatization and stemming, again, I have already discussed in the demo in the first class session. And there's not lot to discuss. The only thing here is like reducing the word to root form. And I already told you the reason why we should reduce a word to root form, because you have a corpus and you have multiple words saying happy, happily, happiness, unhappy. So to convey only one single meaning, why do we need to use at least 4 or 5 words in the corpus? So as people, there's a 80-20 rule, right? 80% of the meaning is conveyed by 20% of words, something like that. Even in the corpus also, even if you reduce happiness to happy, happily to happy, and all the words, if you reduce to the root form also, and most of the times it is observed that the meaning doesn't change a lot, or the application is still accurate to 80%, 90%. There's no much change in accuracy. So that is the but what changes is when you reduce every word to root form, the size of corpus gets reduced. And when size of corpus gets reduced, processing is much, much easier. So that's why people reduce the words to root forms when they do any applications. So if you have am, is, are, then they can be converted into be. They're actually, in fact, from the grammar, they are considered as root forms of be only. Car, cars, cars, just change to car. So lemmatization is always finding a dictionary base for the form, dictionary base form. Okay, it is also called lemmy. It's a French word, I guess. Lemmy is the root form of a particular word. So what here we does is we go to dictionary and we find the root form of the root form of the word and replace the word with root form. It is heavily used in almost every NLP application. And stemming is a lazier form of lemmatization, basically. What do you mean by lazier form? So in the lemmatization, what happens is that if you have to go to dictionary and search for root form every time, it takes a lot of time, very costly process. So what people have come up with is a very basic stemming algorithm, very basic algorithm, which has some rules and which just chops the affixes and suffixes. That's it. It just chops it. And after chopping, whatever the root words are coming, they need not be in the dictionary. And if you see a word like automate, automatic, automation, everything will be reduced to automat. AUTOMAT. And the sad part here is automat is not even there in the dictionary. This is not there even in the dictionary, but the stemming will chop it like that only. So You may question, like, if there is, it's not there in the dictionary, we are losing a lot of information. Yes, we are losing a lot of information. But people have observed, again, instead of using lemmatization, they use stemming. Okay, the accuracy will definitely drop, but sometimes the accuracy drop is not so significant. So lemmatization, you get 80%, stemming, you get 72%. But this is take 3 days to model. This is like 2 hours to model. It's always about balance. Which one do you want? Okay. So the only difference between stemming and lemmatization, it's a popular question in a lot of interviews also. Lemmatization is root form according to dictionary. Stemming is just crude chopping. The root form may not be in the dictionary also. So there is a algorithm called Porter's algorithm. So for lemmatization, you don't need any algorithm as such because it's already going and searching in the dictionary. For stemming, you have a algorithm which says that you have your word ends with SSES, just make it to SS. IES, make it to I. It ends with SS, keep SS. It ends with as S, it ends with S, just cut off it and cut off the S. And verb plus ing form, take only verb. Verb plus ed form, take only verb. So longer stems. So like this, Porter's algorithm, Porter's stemmer, which is very popular, they have defined a lot of steps, first step, second step, third step, fourth step, like that. So this is basically an if else loop kind of a algorithm. So your word will pass through this and pass through this. It will come here. It will come here. At one point of time, one rule will be applicable for it and it got stemmed. Whenever it gets stemmed, the output comes out. So if you, let's say, take word digitizer, it comes here, no condition is satisfied. It comes here, nothing is satisfied. It comes here, it got satisfied. You get it out. So this is basically Porter's algorithm. And of course, Porter algorithm consists of a lot of rules. Basically, you need not go through all the rules. But if someone asks you, how does a Porter's algorithm works, you need to explain this, how steps work, basically. It is like, it starts with plurals. This is basically singulars and plurals. Singulars, plurals, and all. And then it is verb forms. And then there is one more thing called adjective forms. And then for stems, other stems, like that. Someone with typing in the chat, let me see what's that. Praveen, the only reason people go for stemmer is a computational thing only. Stemming doesn't make any sense. So a lot of times, if you have seen the outputs, revival, it is making R-E-V-I-V. It doesn't make sense anything. Activate, it makes active. So it doesn't make sense. The only reason people go for stemming is the computational purpose. It is crude form. It gets your job done very fast. That's it. So these are the major issues with stemming. So he's stalking the supply. She wore a pair of stockings. Okay. In this case, what this should become? Stockings should become stocking plus yes. It's a noun basically. And he's stalking the supplies. It's a verb. So it will become stock. This is the lemmatization output. The stemming output will be stock only in both cases. Right? So it's too aggressive in nature due to its greedy design. Because it's designed to be greedy because you want it fast. Executive is stemmer to execute. Okay? You know how much the difference is there between executive and execute. Okay, execute, on other hand, gives a meaning of punish someone, because most of the court orders for punishing are said to be executed. The court, the prison executed a person today. Whereas executive is something related to a business person. And another biggest disadvantage is if you make the corpus stem and you save only this word stock, and like previous case, we wrote as revive. You save only this, you don't save the main corpus, you don't go back to the dictionary. You cannot go back to the dictionary also. And this is still accepted due to reasonable accuracies plus robustness. The reason people call it robust is also like it works like, see, lemmatization doesn't work if the word doesn't is not there in the dictionary. Okay. Or even there is a very small spelling mistake also, lemmatization doesn't work. Stemming doesn't have anything to do with dictionary. It already have some rules basically. Likewise. You can read it for yourself. Raghu, it specifically depends upon the application basically, especially semantic applications where you say semantic matlab applications from meanings. Let's say your application has more to do with meaning of the sentences, then definitely you cannot afford to go for lemmatization. Let's say you are doing a sentiment analysis. So for sentiment analysis, your adjectives are very important. So when your adjectives are very important, your chopping of the words, your adjectives might be lost. It's a good idea to go for lemmatization only. You're doing some classification algorithm. So in a classification algorithm, I always bother about features basically. That unhappiness, happiness example I talked about is features. So in a classification algorithm, I don't bother about meaning. It's just the word is there or not kind of applications. Then I don't really bother about lemmatization. I'll go for stemming. Again, it depends upon the use case mostly. Okay, so Praveen, this is an interesting question. When you say native languages like Telugu and Hindi or let's say any other Indian languages, we don't have a major problem with difference between stemming and lemmatization here. The reason is our languages are very strongly structured such that if you just stem it, it will become a lemmy only. There's no other form of stemming, something like that. Right. Wow, wonderful. Wonderful way of thought, Amanjit. Like, see, this is a rule-based thought. Okay. As I discussed in the initial stages, every rule-based algorithm, people are trying to do machine learning on it. And definitely we can do a machine learning algorithm on it because every rule can be a pattern in the classification algorithm. Yes, appreciate that way of thought. How does stemming and lemmatization work in? Okay, Raghu, again, good question. Like, basically, when we take antonyms, so when you take antonyms, lemmatization will go for root form and gives you happy only. Root form of happy or unhappy, happiness, everything will come to happy only. Whereas stemming is, as stemming is concerned, it depends upon, stemming doesn't chop the prefixes. Stemming only chops suffixes, basically. Yes. So un doesn't get chopped basically. So un doesn't get chopped. Lemmatization, it will go to root form basically. Yeah. So it's a linguistic based process which identifies roots and morphology, returns basically. And finally, coming to sentence tokenization, as we done with the word tokenization, the sentence tokenization. Okay, when I say sentence tokenization, it is not, it's making sentences out of a paragraph. This is a slide which we already have discussed. So basically, whenever there is a full stop comes or exclamation comes, people say, okay, the end of the sentence. But what if there's a salutation, Dr. Kalam, how do you do it? I completed the meme. No ambiguity, basically. Where are you coming from? Very clear. What is an enticing music? Very clear. So if you come across any three sentences, first three sentences, you'll make it a sentence directly in a paragraph. Okay, it started with question word and it ended with exclamation, this sentence, like that. But how, if you take full stop here, if you end with a full stop, then it might not be the end of the sentence. It can be a salutation also. So this is a problem, ambiguity. And sentence tokenizers are built to solve this kind of problems. So they figure out whether it is the end of the sentence or not, depending upon the previous word or the next word, something like that. So machine learning plus rules plus regular expressions will give you a perfect sentence tokenizer. Okay, let's do sentence tokenization now and sentence token lemmatization, lemmatization in stemming on the Jupyter notebook. And if we have time, we'll discuss about WordNet. Sentiment. Himanshu, sentiment will not be lost because a path of sentiment will be lost, definitely. I mean, if you are using a superlative form, happiest, it will be converted to happy. So you'll be still be with happy, but the intensity is lost. So lemmatization definitely lose the intensity. Okay, let me go to Jupyter notebook. We're doing sentence stemming and lemmatization. This is a very small exercise. Okay, import NLTK. So this is where to stem. No harm in skipping stemming and lemmatization. It's not a must always. Okay, guys. Just have a look at it. Try this first line. There's nothing much to explain. You can have a look at it and try it on. Okay, guys. What's the status? Typing it, testing it. Just a moment, guys. I stopped screen share. Starting it again. Okay. Have you observed here when you are doing stemming, catchy has become CATCHI, which is very irrelevant. Trapping, trap in, driven. Driven has not changed anything. So we'll look at automotives in the first step also. Let's do automobile. It's automotives, it's automotive. Automate, it's automotive. So multiple words which have different meanings also, we do crude stemming. So there are again two or three stemmer algorithms. I have tried to use two stemmer algorithms here, Porter stemmer as well as Lancaster stemmer. There will be some trivial changes, but whenever you get to the application part and you really need two or three differences, changes in different stemmers, then you can research about it. Now, don't worry about what is the difference. So I'm just using a Porter.stem. Tokens is not defined. It's like tokens two. Okay, I didn't define this. Right. In driven. So it's almost the same thing. We have got which stemmer depends on the application. Porter stemmer is something which is most commonly used. So stemming lemmatization is cutting into word into root form if it exists in the dictionary. So WordNet lemmatizer is one of the good lemmatizer. So I have used stemming as well as lemmatization here. Let's try to see. Yeah. Okay. If you have observed, let me show you the cell type, current output, clear. Okay. I'm executing this. Guys, see how fast the stemming is doing, lemmatization is doing. Okay. It's stored in the cache, I think. That's why it's coming. If you use new words, if you have noticed some time back, stemming has come very fast. Lemmatization has come very slow. If you see woman, woman is woman in the stemming. But if you do lemmatization, it became woman. It will came to singular form. Supreme, supreme. So there are a lot of such differences in stemming and lemmatization. Let's see what it's doing for stocking. Yes. Lemmatization is keeping it as stocking. Stemming is making it to stock. So lemmatization considers it as a noun and keeps it. Yeah, yeah. Amanjit, I'll do that. So finally coming to sentence segmentation or sentence tokenization. So you can download tokenizers from punct english.pickle. There's a way to not download, it's just loading the tokenizer. And I'm just loading the text also. If you see, the text is something like this. These are some letters written in NLTK corpus Gutenberg. Gutenberg is a very good corpus basically. And when you do sentence tokenizer.txt, should I use just print? Should be working on print. Okay, it's not working. Import, right? Import. Right. So pprint prints in the proper way. I'm just printing the sentences. Here, the sentence tokenization has been done. So although it appears very trivial application for us, what is there much in that? Tokenizing sentences is also one of the important tasks. Okay, you can try this, guys. Have a look at it. If you are still with lemmatization, do lemmatization, and after which we can proceed to sentence segmentation. Okay. Just a moment, I'll do it. Yeah. Can you see now? Yes. Praveen, I have already started uploading the notebooks immediately after the class. You can see the regular expression notebook in the course already. This will be shared immediately. This will be uploaded immediately. No problem. And the recordings will take 24 hours. We'll do it by tomorrow. But the only thing I'll ask you guys, don't please copy code and paste it in your Jupyter notebook and do it. I know copy paste is like a very easy thing to do, but please type even if I have given the code to you, so that you'll get good with syntax. There's nothing like best lemmatizer. Of course, there are many implementations. I would say WordNet is one of the really good lemmatizer, because WordNet is a library which is started by Princeton University, and a lot of students and a lot of man hours has been spent. Of course, we'll discuss about WordNet separately. Very extensive work has been done by them. So I don't think there is something which beats WordNet. Okay, folks. Yes, stocking is not converted into stock because stocking is taken as a noun. So again, the first step in lemmatization is like it takes the word which is most frequently used in the general context. So stocking has been, in the case of lemmatization, stocking has been taken as a noun only. So when you take it as a noun, there's no point in making it to a root word. Because stocking as a noun is a garment to wear. WordNet, Sridhar, WordNet is not just a corpus. In fact, it's like a tree structure of a dictionary. So WordNet is a dictionary, I would say, but it is arranged in the form of a tree, making it useful for multiple applications, basically. So people call it as WordNet library. Of course, NLTK WordNet lemmatizer is a lemmatizer which is built on WordNet corpus, basically. Guys, keep on trying sentence segmentation if you're done with lemmatization. And feel free to use your creativity and try different things here. Let us know. You can represent still it in a graphical format, but even as a data structure also, it is a tree structure. We'll discuss that. WordNet discussion is there. There's a whole 20-30 minutes discussion on WordNet. Yes. So people have come up with different corpus, actually. FastNet or let's say FastText. Again, it's from Facebook. There is even before that, this one more library I forgot, which has come up with very, very fast implementations. But the reason I used NLTK is like it's still industry standard and it can do a lot of applications. Once we get to the NLTK, maybe one day we can dedicate it to other applications as well. Yes, yes, Stasi. Yeah, you are right. Stasi, even in the Word2Vec applications also, when you go to Google, Word2Vec have become very popular. Then there come a Glow embeddings, which became even more popular. RNNs and LSTMs ruled the NLP world, especially and sequence to sequence models also. Then someone came with CNNs for text. And in last 2 years, 3 years, people have come up with different applications for CNNs in text also. So yeah, things have been going in a very fast pace. Edward, for production, it depends upon the company you are staying in, basically, I would say. So there are companies which ask for writing everything from scratch. Okay. They don't want to use either NLTK or FastText also. They want to implement everything from the scratch. And if you, again, you're a small company, you can ship with NLTK, ship it with that FastText. So it depends upon client requirements and your particular applications, basically. There's a company called OpenText in Hyderabad. Where they employ a lot of people. So they build their own libraries. So yeah, they employ PhDs, statisticians, linguistic experts, and they build their own libraries. Because when you build your own libraries, you'll be more fast and prolific, and the IP stays with you. A lot of advantages are there. Okay, folks, I hope you have done this text loading. After you load it, you can use just sentence.tokenizer.tokenize text. Just type this. If you are in a hurry to leave, you can leave. We'll close this in a minute. Okay, whatever I have to convey, I have to convey. You just practice and you can leave. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for joining. I hope you guys are enjoying this early morning learning. Rupesh, are you enrolled in the course? Just log into the course, see the outline. Yes, the past Jupyter notebooks are there already. When I mean enrolled, it's not the payment you made and joined the live classes. There is a course enrollment invitation sent to you. Check your email. Then you can go to LMS and access it. Okay, just check your email with learn@supervisedlearning.com. And also I see many, a few guys didn't join the course yet. So please check your emails. Everything is there. The WhatsApp chat invite, the Google Drive invite. So don't keep on getting back on email again. Where is this? Where is that? So your email is the best way to get things. Don't be lazy to check email. Please check email. Okay, Guna, I'll create the repository of references or a single document and share it with you. I'll definitely do that. because each module is picked up from different sources. Let's say not one textbook doesn't cover all the realm. So the whole point of 100 hours is like, I want to cover all the realm of this. So you'll find each module in each, maybe more than one textbook, something like that. Okay. Thank you guys for joining. We'll see you next Tuesday. Okay. Have a nice weekend. Enjoy. This weekend, I'll have the Python session. It will be added and an email will be triggered to you at the time with the timings. Okay. And as discussed, we'll plan a weekend session also. Meetup, physical meetup for Hyderabad folks. Not this week, we'll plan next week. I'll let you know, guys. Thank you guys for joining. See you next week. Bye.